Good morning, Cougars, and welcome back to the Cougar Recap. I'm Arjie. Future Farmers of America, also known as the FFA, will be holding their annual Spirit Week. There will be a petting zoo, steer roping, anything but a backpack day. Here's the clip from last year. On Friday, Get Pied is a day where staff members and teachers volunteer to get pied by students. Students who want to pie a teacher can pay money to enter the raffle. BSU is also holding their Spirit Week next week in honor of Black History Month. Starting from Tuesday, quotes related to Black History Month will be said over the announcements. The Spirit Days and lunchtime activities will be announced later on the Weston Ranch page. Leadership page here is the @. And we're here with
Sinai
to talk about BSU Spirit Week. Take it away.
Okay, so since it's Black History Month, we decided to do like a BSU like culture week. And the first day is Tuesday. It's going to be multicultural day. So whatever culture you are, you can wear the attire. And then on Wednesday, it's going to be Sunday's best because in like the Black community, like church is a big thing for us. So just wear like clothes you would wear to church, basically. And then on Thursday, it's Characters Day. We wanted to go for like more like Black characters inspired, but you can do any character if you want to, it doesn't matter. And then for Friday, we're doing it as like Dress as Friday, the movie, which is a very popular movie. So, if you want to dress like a character from the show,
thank you. There was a staff meeting that included Students of the Month and the Community Spotlight. Also, our Cougar Rising winners are Manuel, Alexis, and our leadership student, Allegra. Congrats to all the students, and we're here with Ms. Hill to talk about what is Cougars Rising.
Well, Cougars Rising is our school motto. It's also our positive incentive program. Students are recognized and awarded through arts, athletics, and academics, and just good behavior too. So any staff member can give students a character band each month. And those students are awarded points towards the prestigious Cougars Rising patch, which we present at an award ceremony each year. And their names are also, they go into a weekly prize drawing. We have a great batch of new prizes that student led, so you don't want to miss out on that. Also, make sure that you're wearing your band each week because we are doing incentive call-outs each week too. You may have heard those. So when you wear those bands, come up to the student services window and we have great prizes for you.
On February 20th, there will be no school due to President Washington's birthday. But there will be a volleyball practice at this time. I think we have the time. I don't know. We're here with Mr.
Z.
To talk about how you feel about the winter sports season.
Oh my gosh, the winter sports season was amazing. We had boys soccer, boys basketball, girls basketball all make the playoffs. Girls lost a tough one on Monday. Boys won a hard one yesterday. That was very exciting. And then tonight we have boys soccer. We also had two wrestlers place in divisionals. Maddox Lowe placed sixth, and Jovan Sobranas placed fifth. And that's like, that was pretty impressive because Jovan's a first-year wrestler, and Maddox is only a freshman. So the future is bright for wrestling, too.
Wrestling's going up. What do you expect for the spring season?
For spring season, talking to the baseball coaches, softball coaches, they're excited about their program, so we'll see. Different league. I think they're going to be really competitive. And looking forward to track. Coach April, Coach Clay are excited about what's going on in track. We do host the divisionals again, division four and five. So that will be May 9th and 11th. It'll be here at Weston Ranch.
Busy day.
Busy. Esports is continuing to go on. Boys volleyball. I know they're holding tryouts right now, and Coach Kinlaw was very excited about boys volleyball. So all in all, it's been a great year for sports, but it's been winter's been awesome, but really looking forward to spring too.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Z.
Hey, thank you.
Right here with
Coach Kinlaw
to talk about how our volleyball tryouts going.
Volleyball tryouts are going great. We just started this week. due to basketball, we've gone in the morning from 6:30 to about 8:15 in the morning. So
God,
the boys and I are very tired. But they've been, we've had a lot of kids show up, which is really awesome. A lot of boys are interested in volleyball, which makes it really exciting. And we've had a lot of kids show up, a lot of freshmen show, which is really, really awesome. Especially because a lot of them haven't had a chance to play volleyball in junior high because of the sports leagues. So it's been really awesome to see that they're still interested. So, the kids are really excited. And it's been really awesome way to start my day every morning.
Tiring, but
yes.
What are you expecting from the season?
What I'm expecting from the season, last year we had a ton of sophomores on the team, and now they're juniors. So they got a whole year of varsity volleyball under the belt. So I think we're going to be a lot more competitive this year. We're now in the SJAA. So it's really nice because we can't use the, oh, we're a young team as an excuse anymore. The boys have been working really hard. We've been going during the summer, during winter break, and a lot of kids are choosing to be there on their own time. And now with practice, they're just a really hardworking, great group of young men. So
yes, they are.
It's inspiring as a coach.
Thank you, Coach Kamal.
Yeah, thank you.
And that's it for this week's Cougar Recap. And Akira will be hosting next week.